When I was younger, I saw all these rich people and I wondered, how the hell did they get so rich? So I went and read all their biographies, tried a lot of the habits they talked about, and I figured out which ones worked. These habits helped me create AppSumo into a 9-figure company. In this video, I'm gonna share these exact habits with you. Most of the millionaires, as well as myself that I know, we're never happy. We're constantly dissatisfied. It's not that we're only unhappy because my mom's like, Noah, you're so happy, you are a happy baby. But we're constantly looking for how things can be improved. And that is what I'm noticing from a lot of people who have reached levels of wealth that are 7, 8, 9 figures. What they're thinking of is, hey, how can I make things better on a constant basis? Maybe it's a food dish, maybe it's a product, maybe it's their marketing copy. So for yourself, next time you're working on a product, next time you're making a dish, next time you're just even observing your house, just start noticing and try to be more open-minded to thinking in solutions. Do you have a mindset and a habit in you that as you're starting to see problems, you're starting to always think, oh, that could be better, that could be better. Do I always want to be dissatisfied? No, it's honestly not a great way to live, and it's kind of frustrating, and I'm trying to be more enjoying of the life versus always being like, I don't have this, I don't have that. One way you can do this is literally each day, just write down one thing that you can improve. And this could be in your personal life, this could be in your business, it could be in your relationship, and you'll start thinking, man, there's so many different things that I could always be improving. And I'm not trying to tell you, go be unhappy with your life, but I want you to just start building the habit where daily, you're starting to think, huh, maybe there's no rules, maybe there's no limits, how can I start changing things? So maybe you can start thinking of new businesses from that. Oh man, maybe there's a cool assistant business. Maybe there's a new physical product I can create. So build the habit of always looking for solutions and actually be happy out there. Clear goals with deadlines. So let me just show you again. These are my goals for the year. So my goals for the year are $50 million for AppSumo. And the way that I have clear goals with deadlines, it's not just for your yearly goals, it's when everything you do. I was talking to someone outside here and I said, hey, I need this to happen. She's like, ugh. I was like, okay, by Wednesday. So you need to be really clear with your goals. And I've seen so many people be like, oh, well, yeah, I wanna grow my YouTube. It's like, no, be clear, 100,000 YouTube subscribers. Or for me, as you can see here, I want 250,000 subscribers on this channel. I want more gorgeous people like you. Now, by when? The deadline, by the end of this year. So be more clear with what you're trying to accomplish and when you actually wanna do it by. It will help you build a successful habit. So if you go and look at a lot of your goals, and if you don't have goals, there's a goal setting video somewhere in the description. This is something I literally have done since my 20s. Hopefully I'll be doing it till about 200. And it doesn't just apply to yearly things. Do it for anything. Hey, I wanna actually fix this door. When are you gonna fix the door and by when? Look at what are the goals I have this year? And if you don't have any, perfect. That's the time to start. And if you do have them, see, hey, are my goals clear and are they clear by when I'm gonna accomplish them? If you want more videos from Uncle Noah, I put out 3 juicy business videos every single week to help you with your business or get your side hustle off the ground. Planning your week, reviewing your week, and having an accountability buddy. Yes, it's a trifecta. So let me just show you a live example. So here are the key things I'm doing in my work. I'm making videos, I'm talking to book publishers at AppSumo, I'm doing the CEO search. So point being is that I'm very intentional about my week, and then I take this and actually schedule it throughout my week. So if you look at my week, you can see that I have a lot of those slots scheduled. This is CEO time, this is video time, this is book publishing time. But let's take a look at a previous week's review and I just tell Adam what I did. So I call my emails the week. And so at the end of the week, before I schedule the next week, and I do this every single Sunday, I email Adam what happened. So I said, waiting on a few things, all done solid, done, now waiting on them. So a lot of times Adam will ask me questions about my week. He'll say, I love that you're feeling fresh. Hey, what happened over here? So how can you start this habit today? This upcoming Sunday, just commit to the things you wanna do, put them in your calendar, and send it to one friend, say, hey, here's what I'm gonna do this week. And then the following Sunday, you check back on what you did, talk to the friend, and then plan your next week. See how it goes. Get feedback regularly. So it stings. I will tell you, we did it a few weeks ago. We do a T3B3. Every quarter at AppSumo, as well as on our YouTube team, we do a feedback session. And the T3B3 is, what are the top 3 things I did that you like? What are the bottom 3 things that you did that I did not like? Let me pull it up on screen just to give you an example. This is from Jeremy. So I'm just gonna highlight a few of the things he wants me to improve on. First off, he wants me to be more clear. I can be very ambiguous with my directions. Like, just do that one thing over there. 2, if I'm having a bad day, like I did yesterday, I let that spill over into my meetings and sometimes they're unproductive where I need to just really check out of the meeting or reschedule. 3rd, sometimes I come with a strong opinion and I'm not really listening. Jeremy, I've got big ears. I should listen better to you, buddy. Now for yourself, I think this is something you can literally start right now. So if you have a phone and you have someone you work with or you have a significant other or you have a friend, all you have to say to them is via text is, hey, Jeremy, what do you think are 3 things that I can improve on? And you will be amazed how this makes you a better human and a more successful business person. This is a habit I highly recommend you start right now. Throw it in your calendar so every 3 months it's like, hey, it's quarterly feedback time. Guess what? I didn't have to remember it because it's automatically built in the calendar. Number 5, my daytime and nighttime books. So yes, one of the habits is to read. So yes, go read books. You've heard this before. I was wondering, how did I actually build reading and learning into my life? Because if you go to goodreads.com/Noah Kagan, you'll see I'm reading a lot of books. Find books you really enjoy. It could be fiction, it could be nonfiction, it could be biographies, whatever it is. But the habit and the way that I've built it a habit is I do a daytime and a nighttime book. On my bedstand is generally a Kindle or a physical book. That's more likely a fiction book that I'm excited to read. So the other thing I do is then on my table, which is my daytime book, I always have a physical book that's annoyingly in the middle of my kitchen table. Literally, because I'm seeing these books and they're in those two places, like when I got into bed a few nights ago, I was gonna watch Mythic Quest from Apple TV and I saw the book and I was like, nah, I'd rather read the book. That's part of my habit. Because it's there and I'm seeing it all the time, and if the book sucks, exit out. Number 6, I follow through when no one's looking and I don't negotiate with terrorists. So this is an interesting habit that I really want you to think about. This is a very common thing. All of us commit to something. Hey, I really wanna work out. Hey, I wanna build this project. And then you get home, and then you're tired, and then the TV's on, and then you have some pizza, hopefully pepperoni, and you're just like drained. And then you start negotiating. Well, you know, I've had a long week. And so what I've noticed for myself, and anytime I start negotiating, that's the habit that I want to be breaking. When I said, hey, I committed to actually studying airplane tonight, and you have to be clear. So I said I would study for at least an hour. Okay, maybe I won't do it. Leave a comment below if that's something you've ever done. I know I still do it to this day. I'm not perfect. I'm human just like y'all. And that's a habit though that I think if you can get in the habit of, hey, I'm gonna do this thing and I follow through, and no matter if anyone else is watching, that is such a superpower for you to be able to accomplish whatever you want. Number 7 of millionaires is they track their finances regularly. This is what helped me become a millionaire and beyond. In the community tab, if you're a subscriber, we'll put this template out there. And what the template does and why I think you should make it a habit is each month, look at your net worth. And it's really, really simple. This template is literally, what are my assets? What are my liabilities? So assets are cash, your index funds, whatever that is. And your liabilities, maybe you have a mortgage, maybe a credit card. And I see my net worth. And so because I'm habitually tracking my net worth, I can grow it. My business partner Chad says this thing and I really love it. It's like, whatever you track will grow. It doesn't mean magically it'll grow just by putting on a spreadsheet, but whatever you're focusing on and you're saying, hey, each month. So on January 1st, let me show you my calendar. The first of every month, it says personal finance update. This is auto repeated every single month. And I look at it every single month and I still do it manually. I don't know, this is now probably 15 years later. And so building that as a habit, one, it helps me take my finances more seriously, and it helps me know where the hell I'm going. So if I'm way off track, like I wanna get to a million or 100,000 or 10 bucks, whatever it is, I can now start planning to get there. So I highly recommend that on one, at least once a month, start looking at your finances. You don't have to be a stock investor. You don't have to be a Dogecoin buyer, oy vey, but you do have to make it a regular thing that you're saying, hey, money is important to me. Let me take a look at it, see where I am, see where I wanna be, and make sure that I'm on some level of a path. You do this once a month, I promise you, you will get to some levels of wealth that you never thought you could. So number 8 non-obvious habit that I highly recommend you do is they prioritize meetings with really interesting people. So literally to this day, I'm still actively, it's a habit. I can't stop reaching out to people that I find interesting, men, women, whatever. And I make it a regular thing where I'm like, hey, how do I hang out with interesting people? So next week, I found some people that are interesting that are doing paleo. I said, hey, come over, we'll cook some paleo food and talk about it. Eamon through Runs Up Sumo. I met him through Charlie Hohen, who I met through Tim Ferriss. So for you, what I highly recommend you build as a habit is even if it's once a week, compliment someone you like. And even if you want to go further than that, I think building the habit of meeting interesting people, maybe starting a podcast where once a week you talk to people. But the idea of meeting people on a habitual basis, meaning it's something just built into you, I promise you will be so rewarding. Even if you never make money out of it, it's just fascinating and it makes life so much more colorful meeting people. So ways that you can meet people, set up dinners, send compliments, just hit them up and be like, yo, I really like you. Can we have a 5-minute talk about the things you're interested in? What I personally do, and I've talked about this, is I have a note on my iNotes that says 52 weeks of people. So as I find anyone who's kind of interesting, I just put them on here and I'm like, well, hopefully one day I can meet them. And on a regular basis, I'm trying to reach out to these people and connect with them. So some of the ones is like Dan Held, who's a Twitter guy on crypto. Seth P from Grubhub, this guy's really interesting. Ivan Soto from MoonPay, CT Chen. My point here for you is make it a habit of connecting with people at least on a weekly basis. Give yourself your own list of 52 weeks of interesting people. So here's some obvious habits, and I'm gonna give you ways that you can do these, but I'm gonna go through this quick, but these are ones you've probably heard of, so you're not as excited to go implement them, but frankly, there's still ones that I do to this day, and I find them really helpful. So first off is they make lists and they follow through. You've heard this before from a lot of other people, but I recommend you do it. This is literally my 6-8-21 list. So every night or first thing in the morning, I make a list of what's the most important things, can't see it, most important things to do today. Making a list is important because you know, hey, this is really important for me, and ideally it ties to your main goals. But the second thing is following through. The more that you can build up your confidence and start doing a list and you're like, hey, I'm accomplishing my list, you're like, yo, dog, I can do anything. Flex on them, do it. Number 10, they exercise. So again, you've heard this habit. How do you make it easy? Just start small. So literally every day, walk 5 minutes. That's a super easy thing. And if you can do that, then you can start pushing yourself on harder levels of exercise. But the reason I think exercise is an amazing habit for success, when I can accomplish something physically really hard, then when I'm like doing this computer crap, type, so easy. And it's a good practice to think, man, I can do hard things. That's why I highly recommend you build exercise as a habit. So maybe it's jump rope 5 minutes. Maybe it's a walk for 5 minutes. Heck, even do push-ups. All right, I'm gonna do push-ups. Let's do 10. I'll count it out with you.
2 hours later.
Let's go. You can do that right now. A lot of the people who I've met that are multi-millionaires and they're successful, this is like James Clear, Ramit Sethi, a lot of these guys that I've met, women as well, Vanessa Van Edwards, they're like, yeah, I'm reading this book. Yeah, I'm taking this online course. Yeah, I'm going to this program. And I'm like, what do you mean? You've already made it. Why do you stop? What, you're doing that? That is why they are successful. They have built a habit of constantly learning. Tiago Forte, phenomenal guy. I love his stuff. They are constantly still learning. And you kind of think, oh, that is why they are where they are. But a lot of the other people are like, nah, I'm not going to learn. I'm just gonna kind of wing it. It's like, all right, well, you're probably gonna get wing results. Chicken wings are good. But they're not gonna get the great results. So how can you make a habit of constantly learning? So for me, a lot of it's like, what am I curious about? Maybe it's home improvement projects. Last year I was making wine, or now I'm trying to get my airplane license. So think about, how can I be learning? And once you find something you're interested in, guess what? Learning makes that fun. It's not school, you don't have to do it. So find a thing you're personally interested in today and go watch one YouTube video about it. They say no a lot. That's why I always thought my name started with no, because I have to focus. And so they're saying no probably a lot more than you are, meaning to the meetings, to the phone calls, to the emails. What is one thing you can say no to that's really not gonna move you closer to your goals? It helps you focus on what is important. Again, so it is a habit. The habit that you do is each day now, say no to one thing. Not my YouTube channel. This is a new habit, so I can't encourage you to go do it just yet, but I have really found the habit of being quiet a superpower. And so the way that I do this habit to myself is that when I'm bike riding, or when I'm driving, I don't listen to anything. So no podcast, no audiobook, no music, no phone calls. So yes, I do it some of the times, but I have noticed that people are like, yeah, I have a podcast on. I'm like, are you really getting anything out of the podcast? And the answer is no. And so in the past 2 years, I've gone quiet a lot more in my activities, and I have been amazed what's up there. You have way more in your brain creativity-wise and ability-wise than you can ever imagine, and probably than you're gonna get out of any book. So I highly recommend today, block out 5 minutes. And put in your calendar, say, hey, today I'm actually gonna be quiet. Now, in terms of building a habit, every Monday you can do quiet hour. And I've noticed that I always have these things, I call them airplane mode, and I always skipped it. So if you're doing a habit and you're trying to build a habit, find a way to make it easy for you to do the habit. So if you're already biking, or you're doing your walk, or you're doing something, all right, well, how do I try a little bit of it so it makes it easy to accelerate into that habit? And lastly, one of the things I would say to build any habit is the law of 100. So this is something we've talked about a lot on the channel, which is how do you do 100 of something? So it's 100 days of something. So if you want to build a reading habit, every day for 1 minute, I'm going to read. I'm going to go for a walk. Or maybe it's post 100 YouTube videos. So every week I'm going to post one YouTube video. In 2 years, guess what? You'll have a successful YouTube channel. We have a video down below in the description where you guys can see more about that specific thing. If you love this video and you want to hear the full story so that you can copy for yourself about how I made my first million, check out the video right up here. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel, open the